in a perfect world, at the policy level, I would like to see accessible visual language given to all kids who need it growing up, and benchmarks to be established to make sure those kids are making the milestones all the way along at specific ages. Right now, what tends to happen is those kids miss milestones, and nobody is really measuring that or catching them. Then, by the time interventions are established, they've already missed critical phases of their development because they haven't had exposure to an accessible language. I'd like to see the Department of Education prioritize visual language access at an earlier age.
We recruit students who have a Ph.D. in a biomedical or biobehavioral science field, and we're looking for people who are motivated to do basic research along with teaching and learning how to be a good teacher. Part of the program, which is different from most postdoctoral programs, is this component that allows you to learn how to teach rather than just throw you into a classroom and expect you to teach.
My training was in clinical psychology, so the people I really worked with were deaf adults who were part of the mental health system. In that experience, I saw a trend of who tends to come into the mental health system. They're people who have experienced language difficulties at one point or another. So what I'm doing here at U of R now is I'm trying to look at where I can start to explore that early language experience and how that can affect later life.
Well, we have a lot of opportunities for different people and different types of biomedical degrees. It's not just one type of science, it's a broad spectrum of biomedical science degrees, behavioral science. So we're interested in motivated and skilled folks who want to come and join our program.
Rochester is one of the most accessible cities in the U.S. for deaf people because many deaf people stay here after they've come here to attend RIT or NTID. We also have Rochester School for the Deaf here. So most of my friends from college are still here.
Rochester has the largest population per capita of deaf people in the United States, if not maybe, you know, the world.
There are events in the community that are interpreted, movies that are captioned, various festivals and deaf events, and many places where interpreters are provided without a lot of hassle. So we don't have to think about access as much here because it's given automatically. Rochester is a very deaf-friendly community, and it takes off a lot of the stress of being deaf in a hearing world.